it's Kristen and welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having an awesome day. So for today's video, we have quite a bit of a long build, but I don't really mind it, you guys, because I actually have quite a bit to talk about with this build. So this has been a long time coming. If you guys actually watched the 100 Baby series that I have on my channel, you knew that this build was due to come. So if you guys have never checked it out, I actually post it every single Wednesday and Sunday, 3 p.m. Atlantic time, and it's a very dramatic series. But anyways, we do have the third heir of the 100 Baby series that actually has just began to take over. She is expecting her very first baby, and as of right now, she is like still living with her mom, Gracie. I'm gonna get some names mixed up just because it's kind of new. I feel like every time you start with a new heir to the challenge, you always like get mixed up because you're just like so used to referencing the parent all the time. But I am so excited because we have definitely been preparing for this for a very long time. Now the unfortunate thing is with the new heir, Willow, she has the unflirty trait. Like, what are the chances? And there actually has been a lot of you guys that have been commenting like different ways to kind of work around it. And I did put a poll. I'm asking you guys if you wanted me to change her traits. Now I know that like the majority of you guys, I think it was like 90 some percent of you guys said that yes, it was okay to change her trait, but I kind of went through the challenge rules again, and I don't know if I'm just overlooking it, but I actually never seen where you were able to change that. So as you guys know, I have not cheated in 100 Baby, and we are on the third generation, and we are at the halfway mark for this challenge. So I'm like, you know what? We are not gonna begin to cheat in this challenge yet. I mean, she is just beginning, and she was able to get pregnant on her first try. So some of the things that we did end up doing was we really took advantage of those incense that you can light, like romantic sandalwood, I think it's called. And we also had her use some of her aspiration points or the perk points, and she was able to actually have that drink that makes you flirty. So there is another one that we are gonna be working for, which is the beguiling trait. I'm probably saying that wrong, but that actually really helps to increase whoever you begin to talk to, like that will help increase their flirty mood, which is definitely gonna help. But the only thing is, because Willow is unflirty, I feel like she's just gonna be a constant issue. So I did get a comment on the last episode, and I actually did not know this was a thing. I haven't really played too much with like the traits, or not the traits, I haven't really played too much with the perk store. So there are quite a few of them that I kind of don't exactly know how they work. And one of you guys, I actually have a screenshot of it. I will, if I remember, post it or put it in the video, that one of you guys actually did let me know there was a perk that you could retrain your sim. So it's not gonna be chaining because you are allowed to use any of the perk points that you want. That's actually just like part of the game. So I think what we are gonna do, the only issue is it's 5,000 points. And if I am correct, I remember with Gracie having to save up those 5,000 points for the money tree, it took forever. So we definitely have our work cut out for us, and I do need to double check it in the perk store on the next episode, and if it is something that you can actually like retrain your sim and like give them a completely new trait. Like, that is the only one that I want to change. Like, I want to keep everything else that she has for traits. I would just like to maybe swap out that unflirty for flirty. So that is definitely something we are going to be working for. And like I said, it's 5,000 perk points, and I feel like it's definitely taken us a while to even earn like 400 to get those like two potions. So we definitely do need to get working on that for sure. So, I mean, considering she was able to get pregnant right away, I feel like as long as we kind of like pull over some of the, like, the people that we meet, as long as we like bring them to the home and we use like a lot of those incense, I think that one would be like really good. So I don't exactly know when Willow is actually going to be moving into this home, and to be honest, I don't really know when I'm posting this video. I'm just kind of like sitting down to get it ready because I'm so excited to show you guys this. Now what we are going to be doing as of like right now as I'm recording this is Willow is actually living in the basement right now. She just kind of like started out, originally that is where the butler was. And that's kind of something that I want to go over, like different things that I have learned through the different like eras of the challenge and the different homes that we have had. I've definitely kind of learned things that work and things that don't. For me personally, I mean, everybody definitely has their own way of kind of like playing the game. So when I first started playing, it was rough, you guys. Gameplay alone, I was like so new. I was a builder. And that's kind of why I started the challenge, and now I'm like so in love with it. But originally, when we first started with the first heir, April, you guys might remember her. And if you've been here for a while, the first episodes were very rough. Oh my gosh, you guys, there even was an episode, I don't know if you guys remember, but I did not have my headphones on. And so like I could not hear anything that was going on in the game, and I posted the video. And I think it was Aaron or Blake or Bobby. Anyways, one of the babies was like completely screeching and crying in like the whole entire video. So I'm like still getting comments about how I'm like the worst Sims mom because like my baby just like cried all the time. And I'm like, oops. Because that was so long ago. I'm even like embarrassed watching that back. But honestly, I feel like I have grown so much doing this challenge. And I highly recommend, of all the challenges that I have played through, I highly recommend this to anybody that really wants to get better at playing, because you really dive into playing with like every single one of like your ages. You definitely need to max out your parenting skill, because you are gonna have a ton of babies. Now, those are the ones that I dread the most. Not gonna lie, I always thought it used to be toddlers, but no, babies. They just like scream and they cry. And I really hope soon that we will get like an update for babies that we can like teach them to crawl. Even if we have like swings, strollers, oh my gosh. If we had strollers for babies, if we were ever to get that in an update, I would cry. Like, I would legit cry. I would be so happy, because I honestly feel that babies and elders in game are so neglected by the Sims team in general. They're just like, yep, nope, nobody cares about them. But honestly, I would love to see some kind of like an elder pack or a newborn pack. I don't know if I'm the only one, but honestly, I just feel like they are so, they have like nothing to do. Like Gracie, for example, who is the first heir, or yeah, the second heir, who actually has like just retired from like having babies, I guess you could say. She like has nothing to do other than paint and like help prepare her daughter Willow, who's gonna be moving in here. Like there is nothing for her to do. So she's just kind of like hanging out with Erwin at the house. And we can't like go to bingo. There's like nothing other than like having events. But I really wish there was like some kind of groups. Maybe that's what we could do. Maybe we could like make a group for her. Maybe, oh my gosh, we should totally have a bowling group for, oh my gosh, for Gracie. If I forget to do that, definitely make sure to like flood out the comments of the next episode, because I might forget to do that. And hopefully she doesn't die before we do that, actually. Because we did just get the notification to like make every day the best for Gracie, because she's like getting ready. Oh my gosh, I'm thinking about it and I'm like getting heart palpitations. I have honestly, you guys, I have grown to love this family, honestly, like my own. I mean, I spend so long with this family every single week, twice a week, and it's been going on for like over a year. So I mean, this is now like part of my weekly routine, is to like check in with the family. And I honestly, I am so attached to them. Like even when Willow was able to kind of let Gracie know that she was pregnant, I actually legit teared up. Like I know that I talked about it in the video, but like that was actually a thing. Like I even talking about it now, like I am just so happy that they have been able to like pass the torch on and just like start like a new life. And I am so excited. Now you guys might actually be looking at this home and being like, holy freaking crap, why is this home like so big? But that is kind of something that I wanted to go over. I kind of got sidetracked a little bit, but okay. This home, I can say honestly, looks way bigger than it actually is. because it's only a bungalow. The upper level actually is not livable right now. And I did, like I said, take inspiration from like some of my other builds. I have two bungalows in particular that honestly I would rebuild a million times over because I just love how they turned out. So I ended up taking some inspiration from those two builds. If you guys scroll through my home builds, you definitely will be able to pick them out. I think they've been like 6 months older, maybe even like a year ago. But I really wanted to pull those because, like I said, we are in this home so much. So I really wanted this to be like a home I would actually move into if I was to see it like in real life home shopping. And I definitely can say that this is it. So you are gonna see that there definitely is some slight luxuries in this home, but there definitely is a lot of things that we are gonna need to improve. The gardens are also completely empty, because that is something, like all of that kind of stuff is completely empty. We've just kind of like made a pathway so that we can begin, because I mean, that is the whole point of 100 Baby, is like earning your own money and figuring out exactly like what your heir is gonna do to earn money. So the kitchen floor, a lot of you guys might be like, oh my God, how did you use that base game tile? But honestly, I still love that tile. And I mean, over time, once Willow is able to like start earning her own money, we will be able to start upgrading things. And I love these counters, so I definitely needed to use those. But we do have starter appliances and like all of the sinks and plumbing, so we definitely are gonna be having like a lot of issues with those things as well. What else did I do? So yeah, I definitely made sure that over time, like I'm probably gonna say Willow and Grace, I'm gonna be like have them mixed up, but when it comes to Willow, I really have high hopes of her being able to make a lot of money. And over time, I really would like to expand this upstairs. You guys have probably seen with Gracie's home, that is kind of what we were able to do. We started with a one level home and we were able to just like continue to expand that one. And that is definitely the plan for this. So the bedrooms are really teeny tiny. I'm actually kind of nervous about not being able to have enough beds for everybody. So we might have to like make do with like the sofa. That is kind of the part of like starting from scratch. And I wanted to, like I said, this home is small, so we really had to make do with all of the space that we did have. So when I started out with the first generation or the first heir, we ended up living in an apartment because I thought, oh my gosh, if we had like a little tiny home, that would be so adorable because we would be able to keep track of everybody. But we honestly ran out of space so quickly. And unless you are living over in like some of those like multiple level apartments, or those apartments that are like super huge, I think it's called like the Lobo apartments. The guy with like the fancy tux owns it. If you know what I mean, he's like the fancy landlord. But unless you are living there, it is really a struggle to live in apartments, and you always have your neighbors causing trouble, like keeping you up, waking up your babies, waking up your children, and all of that stuff. So we ended up being able to save up money. We had April move into another home, and I think it was definitely bigger than this just because she took out a loan, which I think we're gonna have actually Gracie pay back the rest of the remaining, because Gracie honestly was able to make bank. She would have been the second heir. I mean, we were able to get like over $100,000 easy because she was able to like save up money, or save up the perk points to get like that money tree. So like, yeah, we were kind of rich for a moment. We are not gonna have that because unfortunately we did have the money tree die, which it's fine because honestly we were not gonna like plan to bring the money tree over, because honestly being rich really made the whole entire game way too easy. So I never had intentions to do that. You guys probably know because I've said it all the time, but I was like, you know what, this honestly, we don't have anything to work for, we don't need to like grind for nothing. We never had any of the power turned off like we did with April. So I can say that April's home was probably one of my favorites when we moved. If you guys remember, like when we had the cow plant before she actually like died of laughter, and yeah, it was tragic. But that home was probably one of my favorites. And then when her child the youngest child, Gracie, took over as the second heir. We kind of started in a smaller home, and because we had so much money, we just kind of like continued to build this like master mansion. We had expanded it just on every angle. We've expanded it out on the sides. We even was able to make like a whole other level that was like the size of this upstairs again. And I mean, we had so much space that we honestly didn't even really know what to do with, or me. I felt like we even had a skating rink in the backyard. Like, we just had so much space and so much money that it honestly was just like a little bit overwhelming, to be honest. So that is definitely one thing that I wanted to do for this home, was a little bit of a happy medium. So I feel like because this is a bungalow, and if we do find ourselves kind of running out of space, there is a bonus area that is outside off of where like the garage is. You guys probably seen it. I left it empty on purpose because that is gonna kind of serve as a room for once we get playing in this particular home and we find out maybe we need a spot for fitness stuff, maybe we need like an extra bedroom or a bathroom. Maybe we even want to have the mom have like her own space. So that's going to kind of be something that the actual like challenge will like navigate to us. So we do have that one bonus room out there, and we have four bedrooms. So the difference between this and the home that we have already. So the home that we had before with Gracie has 1, 2, 3, 4 bathrooms, and then it has 2 bedrooms downstairs, a giant playroom, and then upstairs it does have like a whole, oh my gosh, you guys, there's like 2 bedrooms with like 4 beds in each of those. We have like a giant bonus room that we never really knew what to do with, which we made like karaoke. We even had an arcade machine, and then we even had an extra bedroom that was able to like turn into a gym. So downstairs, honestly, it's probably like the size of this living room, or like how we have the playroom area and the living room here. That was like how big just the playroom is. So I kind of, like I said, wanted to make a happy medium with this, and I really love those rounded tables. So I wanted to pull the inspiration from Gracie's home. We have that rounded table, and I'm gonna test out having laundry. I might like scream and cry and delete that out in the first episode, but oh my gosh. Okay, I'm getting too excited, handsy. But that might be actually something that I do end up deleting, but it's been a while since I have played with laundry. So I did put the stackable washer and dryer in here. It might end up being very expensive. And I just realized that I also forgot to put in a thermostat as well. So we do have, I'm trying to like follow the camera. So over in here, we do actually have like the living room, but like I said, I didn't want to overdo it with the rooms. So I pulled the playroom area into the living room, and then I brought that same flooring over that has like the puzzle pieces, and I just kind of made it look like it was a mat. And then we have like a few different things. So one thing that I am forgetting was a bookshelf. So that is going to be something we are going to need to work and save for. And we also need to remember to pack up our paintings, and we also need to pack up those paintings and the family paintings. So we definitely need to make sure to remember, I say we, it's us, it's our series, but we definitely need to make sure to put those in Willow's inventory before we move over here. And we also do need to take some of the like pieces of the plants that are outside. And I am thinking also bringing that bee box over. Let me know if you guys think we should bring it. I am thinking of bringing the bee box and Patchy over, just because I think that would be a really fun thing to kind of like remember our home. So we do have a little teeny tiny gardening area outside compared to like how much space that we had, but we do have a lot of extra yard area. So like I said, we haven't really been able to figure out what we want to do with Willow and how she earns her money. We haven't figured out if she's going to be like a writer or a painter or a gardener. She possibly could be a baker. I mean, we have no idea yet. So I also kind of wanted to, there is like a yard sale table that is in the build and buy, and I haven't really played around with that too much, but I am considering setting that out on the front yard and maybe like have the kids be able to like go around and dig things and see if we can like sell those. I have no idea how it works. It might not even like be a thing that we can do. So I definitely need to hear what you guys think of Willow and what you think she should do to be able to afford this home. So in case some of you guys are like, wait, why is there like no furniture outside or anything? But like I said, this is the beginning of the home for Willow. So as she kind of earns more money, we will be able to grow this home and really kind of customize it to our family. So I also do need to save up for like an entertaining area outside. You guys can see that I kind of extended the balcony just because I thought it was a little bit too small. And I think a little fire pit, maybe with some seating and a barbecue, would be amazing out there where the lanterns are. And I also want to put a few like planter boxes to kind of like expand where our gardening is as well. But I really do hope that you guys did enjoy this home build. Of course, make sure to give this a very big thumbs up. It always lets me know you guys did enjoy. And of course, make sure to subscribe with notifications on. And hopefully, I'm gonna see you all next time. Bye, guys.